It's made to be crappy on purpose. To an extent, that's just gratuity.
Some people think that those things are good, though. Like,
they have no taste.
Normal.
Isn't there that one guy that, like, made a really shit movie, but still thought it was good?
It's pretty much everyone who ever makes a movie.
I know what you're talking about. We use the troll defense. Like, I was fooling around the whole time. Ha ha. And no one bought it.
Well, nope. Troll 2. Troll 2 was
no one
bad.
Proclaimed that that movie was messing around the whole time. Everyone proclaimed it was serious or something.
It's another movie that was no good.
I mean, it's funny, but it wasn't supposed to be.
What, Troll? Yeah, it was supposed to be.
The first Troll is boring.
Well, they're not actually connected.
I know.
Yeah.
I love it. The kid's name is Harry Potter in the first Troll. His name is Harry Potter.
I know Elaine from Seinfeld, isn't it?
So what, you started the recording already?
Troll 1 or 2?
Troll 1. She got naked. That's the only thing I remember from it.
Oh, of course.
She became a druid. And apparently that means you take all your clothes off.
Yeah. I mean, druids are weird, man. Real druids are cool, but like, fiction druids
Sorry, not
crazy.
Druid. Dryad.
Dryad.
Yeah.
Okay.
Those are even weirder.
Yeah.
They're so pretty, you go blind or just spontaneously die.
Aren't the dryads like the half-spider things?
No,
that's a dryder.
Yeah. These are the tree people.
Dryads are the...
Yeah, Brennan, get your monster straight.
Dryads, they're the sexy trees, essentially.
Right.
Don't fuck that. You'll get splinters everywhere.
Yeah. And you might get Dutch Elm disease. Don't ask me how, you might just get it anyway.
Bark man, think about it. Think about it.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
It's actually Joe Barkman.
Oh boy. Started on a good foot here.
Okay, I need to screen some dice, because I actually brought the minis with the dice.
I've only got mine, and I don't have any.
I'll grab more.
You can have. Oh, wait, Brennan has you.
Brennan's taking care of me.
Taking care of business.
Every day! Did you guys see Doomsday, Apocalypse, whatever it's called?
No.
No?
I probably will.
I can see it for free, so. Well, I can see it.
What have you heard about it?
Meh.
I hear it's meh. Oh, decent. It's decent.
I actually want it to fail, so...
So that I can join the cinematic universe?
You know what? Sure. Out of pettiness, I'll hope the movie fails.
Which movie?
It's terrible, because that's thousands of people's jobs right there.
I don't care.
Which movie?
It's for the benefit of all of society.
Oh, well, I mean, going utilitarian, are you?
The people who worked on the film already got paid for you.
Quicksilver's
true,
still
but
be
there's
dead,
still
though.
A level what? Of royalty.
Quicksilver's
they get a little
still
bit of money
be dead, though.
Yep.
He'll be dead in either universe.
There you go. Established continuity.
Cross dimensional continuity.
Come on, Fox. Sony's playing ball now too.
It's all about Disney, though. Disney's the end-all, be-all mega corporation of entertainment. Or is slowly becoming that.
They have a monopoly on joy.
Yeah. And anguish.
We can lower the AC with the door closed, though.
Nyet!
And it'll lower the noise.
Nyet!
Hey. It's fine. Don't lower it too much.
I guess the real noise is the fan.
They can turn that down.
Bees! My god.
It's a wasp. That's
that was as low as it goes. It's just noisy.
Yeah. That's death.
I'd rather fight a bee than a wasp any day.
I'd rather fight a wasp than a hornet.
I smell that smell that happens to plastic when you leave it out in the sun too long.
What are you talking about?
Burnt plastic smell.
Are you talking about the dice?
I don't know, am I?
What?
I feel like it kind of smells like a bit of a barbecue-ish.
No. It smells like you put,
a three-year-old's hornet.
Toys on the grill, maybe. Barbecued cheap plastic.
I don't know. Plastic has a very distinct smell when you burn it, and I don't smell it at all.
You don't?
No, I don't smell it either.
Oh, no. Maybe I'm just closing
it. You must have smelled some weird plastic, then.
What are you insinuating? I have plastic?
Yes.
I mean, that would explain some things.
You like to huff lead plastic. Burning lead plastic.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Oh, by the way, Team 4 Stars, their Nuzlocke, they're at the Elite Four. This week's their finale. They're doing a live stream of them.
Which game?
Leaf Green. They got Dragonair, Charizard, Snorlax.
Charizard? Greenleaf.
Well, I mean, they're also doing an abridging contest.
Oh, yeah, that too.
Oh, neat. So are they doing this... sober, or are they doing a Drunk Souls type run?
No, they're doing it sober.
Oh, good. You can't Nuzlocke under anything. That would be a terrible idea.
Gee, well,
turn based, so it wouldn't be that hard.
It was like, let's just do things, speed it up.
The whole joke behind it is to see how badly they screw up.
Yeah.
Well, being that they nearly wiped at Brock, they lost.
Wait, what?
They went in with four guys. They left with one at Brock.
That's scary.
So they've come a long way since then.
Now I've got an idea for a drunk Nuzlocke. Every time one of your guys die, you take a shot.
You'll never get drunk.
Yeah.
They don't die that often. If they did, you'd be done.
Plus, you don't get that many Pokemon. They've got like 30, and about 5 of them have died. 2 of them they've killed off on purpose because they didn't like them.
Okay, what would be a good drunk challenge?
It would be Dark Souls. You take a shot every time you die. That's what you do.
That's what they do.
You will die.
That's what they do. They got up to
35
last night.
No, I mean you'll literally die.
Yeah, that's what... No, Team Forster does that. Last night they got up to 35 drinks.
Nice.
You will be dead.
Yeah, I mean, unless you're like super pro or something.
Where
you beat the final boss level 1 without rolling, dodging, or blocking.
The one guy, he gets better...
Which I saw a video of someone doing that.
Yep.
The one guy, he gets better the more drunk he is playing that game. By the end of the night, he's the best one in the room.
Get good, intensifies.
The last boss they fought last night, they were singing Bohemian Rhapsody through the whole battle. They couldn't get him anywhere close the entire night. Then that time, they get him within one swing of dying before he kills them. Because he finished the song.
Some people are really damn good at these games.
Someone said that the Alola region was... Hoenn 2.
That's what the region is called?
No, Alola.
Yeah, Alola.
So that's what they named the region?
Yeah, and someone said it was like Hoenn 2, Island Vacation Boogaloo.
I like that road. We're finally using Pokemon for tools.
7.8 out of 10, too much water.
It was 8.8 out of 10.
7.8 out of 10, you're both wrong.
I said 7.8.
No, it was 8.8.
It was 7.8.
1.2 out of 10, too hard.
Look it up.
I like the
7.8.
I like the new abilities.
No. Two, like, hey, Omega Red and Alpha Sapphire.
Omega Red and Alpha Sapphire?
Omega
Are you
Ruby.
Sure you want to go? Is that your final answer?
Omega Red.
Is that your final answer?
Oh, boy.
Sorry, you lost the $100 question.
Womp.
Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Final answer.
Good. What Continue.
You get $500.
Both got
for the $1,000 question.
Both got they both got different ratings from IGN.
Really?
To the confusion of the masses.
Even though they're basically the same game.
Exactly.
Which one was higher?
I don't remember, but one of them, one of the two got 7.8 out of 10. Too much water.
Were they reviewed by different people?
Blue or Sapphire?
I'm just
turquoise.
You're both wrong. Emerald, shut the hell up.
Yeah.
Delta Emerald.
I would have preferred that game.
Yeah. The game that.
Yeah, we never got the expansion pack remakes ever. We're never getting Z. Nah. Oh well.
I like the new ability that they've got. Silence. They can't lose stats.
For all the games we'll never get.
The new legendaries, they've got...
That's not a new ability.
It's not a new ability? I've never seen it before.
Clear body.
Yeah, yep. It's got a cool name. Complete iron, whatever it's called.
Noob.
Total steel, something like that.
Total Real steel. Sounds like a workout video.
The total steel package. You'll have total steel apps in 7 days of your money back.
A ghost psychic.
Please tell me this is recording.
What?
No.
Oh. I was surprised to see that the Sun Legendary was...
No, we're totally not recording.
Nope.
I don't know, it's a second
There's no way I've been recording you guys since we started this conversation.
Mm, good.
There's no way I didn't mention when I came back from the bathroom something about it.
Only either. 5 days of your money back. I was happy to see that the Sun Legendary was not in any form
firefighting. Well, not firefighting.
What is it?
It's fire a steel. Psychic steel or something?
No, fire steel and the other one's ghost psychic.
No.
Final form, it is fire water.
It was psychic.
It's psychic steel.
It's psychic steel? I thought it was fire steel.
That's why I thought it might have been, like, maybe not.
Psychic steel, there's a nice combo.
I was pretty sure it said fire steel.
I think that already exists. I'm also pretty sure
it already exists as a legendary.
I know.
Oh, yeah.
Palkia?
I know.
No.
No.
Dialga. A certain robot with, like, four arms. No, those like, are both dragon types.
It's not a robot.
Metal spider.
It's not a robot.
And it's metal spider.
It's a Heatran.
Yeah.
No, Metacross, you dingus!
Yeah, Heatran.
That's not legendary.
Might as well be.
Yeah, Heatran true.
Is fire
steel.
Yeah. True. Yeah,
but it might brutal. As well be, JR.
It's one of the few psychic tanks.
Hmm.
I had a shiny Metacross before. It was cool.
Yeah,
I'm
that's
pretty
fair.
Sure it's fine. I just want
Let's
to check.
Jump into I was, stuff.
I was almost after this. Said fire. Steel.
This one. That all being said, I wouldn't be surprised if it had a fire time special, like a unique move to unique.
Well, Yveltal's was dark flying.
Yeah.
Not what I'm saying. Like, it may
like
be
a move.
Yeah, like it may be psychic steel type, but it might have
like a sun based move.
Yes.
Yeah, some sort of.
Oh, it is psychic steel. Hmm.
Oh, yeah? Which is?
The Ash Greninja be a Mega Greninja.
It is? Yeah.
Cool.
How else would it happen?
Good. I was hoping that fusion wasn't going to be a thing.
Can you imagine that?
Do you really buy into that?
No.
That was a meme
from
years
back. Were people saying
back.
There would be fusions?
I wonder what the secret time. Third legendary is going to be.
A plate of spaghetti.
It's gonna be
Twilight.
Well, there's the sun and moon. What's the third?
Stars.
It could be stars. Or
it's Starfy.
The thing is, we kind of already have like a star-ish.
Yeah.
It's gonna be Jirachi.
Kind of.
Again.
Pokemon.
Who's also
Mega
psychic Jirachi. Steel.
Mega
who's
Jirachi.
Also psychic
there you go.
Steel.
Yeah.
That's the one. That
and
I was
then
thinking.
New one's psychic steel too. The little robot girl.
Huh? Oh, okay.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Robot girl, what are you talking
Which
about?
Which one? The,
Robot girl with the gear for a face.
Oh, that's, I thought that was Steel Fairy.
I had never
oh,
saw
it. Oh, it may have been
so
Steel Fairy,
I don't know
Fairy,
what one that is.
Haven't they done that before, though, with a matchup?
Yeah, the key ring.
Yeah, but it wasn't a legendary.
It's Steel Fairy.
Yeah. Jingly key.
Also, right. I'm not convinced that there's going to be a star legendary, because...
Could be, what else could it be? Black hole?
Earth-based?
Black hole.
Could be black hole?
No. I think it
space
might...
Space itself. There you go. The metaphysical concept of space. And then a Pokemon.
Wait, isn't Ho-Ho That's... already... No, Ho-Ho is rainbow, isn't it?
Wait, we have
that. That was a question,
space
actually.
Space and time, Dialga and Palkia. We can't do it. We can't do space.
Oh, Brennan, by the way, what was the size of that, of how big was that space like, battleship Yamato model at New World?
It was about boxes
you
big.
It was pretty sizable.
No, it was like this,
is it still there?
No, it was bought.
It was bought out a while ago.
We know who bought it. That's the thing. Mm.
We don't know who bought it.
No, just, I'm pretty sure someone said they bought it.
Think Chris would be able to get another one?
No, it's like Matt said he sold it to someone.
Call him. Call up the place.
Mm. I mean, at this point, it's like you might as well just eBay it or something.
Well, I was going to buy another one.
You
want to
pay for all that shipping?
On for a while.
It's very expensive, though. Yeah, like, PS4 expensive.
I'm pretty sure it crazy shipping tagged into it, too. Just buy it from the store. Have it ordered for you and buy it from the store. Mm. Yeah.
The shipping's not going to be that much in comparison.
Oh, like, yeah?
The store would have a premium set on it. It'd probably be more than the shipping cost anyways. Mm.
Well, it is 7 o'clock, so...
Yeah,
oh, I need to be heading out, like, by 9:30. So, like...
I'll kick you on at 9, so there you go.
Hey, shut up.
we'll finish up, like, between 9 and 9:30.
Yeah.
We'll try.
Like, unless we're in combat,
cannot disengage.
Yeah, if we're in combat, then that can't be helped.
Go for it.
So what are they?
$2.
What are they, like rye pretzels?
I don't know. Maybe,
they look like mini bagels, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yep, they're rye pretzels.
Oh, just rye?
Yeah. Rye or pumpernickel?
They're good.
Rye.
I thought they was going to be soft, but they're not.
Huh. No.
They're crunchy.
No, I've had these before. Long time ago in a Jewish deli.
I'll just work on this over time. Continue.
Okay. So, is everybody firm of where we were last time?
As I recall, I was in the
temple.
I was in the temple,
and we were walking,
climbing the stairs to the temple just outside.
Uh huh. Did we make it that far? I thought we just touched down nearby area and we met somebody, I think, right?
Well, we went to the town, but then didn't do anything because we didn't really want to.
Oh, yeah, we moved past that.
Yeah, so we moonwalked back. That's how we traveled all the way up the mountain.
Okay. No shenanigans.
Oh, that's going to be hard.
Yeah, it really is.
You're asking for a lot.
Yeah.
I'm not faced with stuff, so you'll get less out of me.
Mr. Shenanigans is telling us enough shenanigans.
Yeah, exactly. It's ironic.
Can I borrow some dice?
What?
Can I borrow some dice?
This has a kick to it. I like it. Dice with
him. He's got a box of my dice with him. There's a bunch of dice in there.
I think I only need a d20 and d8.
There's definitely a couple bunch of D20s in there.
Oh, sorry, I just need
throw this D6. In that box of mine.
Thank you.
Throw this in my box.
This thing is really hard.
Yeah.
No, we're not recording the other show. We're done with those jokes. We're moving on.
Eric, who should we start on? These guys or?
Yeah, since we ended on you, we'll start with you.
Okay.
Nom nom. I'm going to finish my pretzel.
Did we take a rest between visiting the town and coming up here? Yeah.
Nope.
Oh man, this has been a long while climbing these stairs.
It is.
Did we really end on the stairs? I don't remember.
Yeah, you ended on the stairs.
We've been climbing the stairs for a week.
Yeah, that's how long it took him to realize he had a blindfold on.
Because I believe it was my small perception that was the reason why I didn't know.
Julian is nodding yes.
And making clapping sounds.
That was hysterical.
The clapping sounds like a problem. It has no effect on this dark area. Maybe we'll remove that dark area in time. That was great.
Yep. Our prisoner is special.
Best plot twist ever. He was wearing a blindfold.
Womp womp.
That awkward moment when you're so used to magical effects blocking out the light, you forget that blindfolds exist.
One day I'm just going to have a blindfold on and I'll still be able to see things.
You got blind sight.
Yeah.
He does not have blind sight.
Not yet.
Very few things ever get blind sight.
Yep.
It would be awesome, though.
I'm not sure anything in 5th can even get blind sight.
Bats.
We're not bats now, are we? I'm not sure player characters can get it.
Someone could be a druid and turn into a bat.
Yep.
Batman.
You're not going to be Batman.
Man Bat.
Do you want me to kill your parents?
Man Bat.
Yes.
I killed him already.
You're anti-Bat.
No, then you're not Batman.
No.
Well, I'm a lawyer, so I can be Daredevil.
What?
That's just as good. He also has blind sight.
You have a good point.
So you head up the stairs towards the temple. It's been a long time since you started climbing.
We hear giggling coming from the temple.
It's been a long time getting from there to here.
Okay. One more goddamn references that show, I'm going to kick all your asses.
It was a good show.
You don't want to send me on a tirade, please. It is Enterprise. That show that screwed over Star Trek. It's because of that goddamn pop song that turned off so many of the old school Star Trek fans. The ratings of the show plummeted, and by the time they put an actual theme song in, the ratings were so low and no one was watching the show anymore, which resulted in it getting canceled early. Fuck that song!
Well, it didn't get canceled early. It had an actual ending.
Yeah, shit one!
Yeah, it was a really bad end. Have you seen the season finale of that show?
Yeah, I don't remember much. It was a long time.
Exactly!
Riker's on the holodeck, just looking
He's
at
what
the He's
basically LARPing!
Yeah.
It's Riker LARPing! Yeah. You made me break my pretzel, Brennan!
He's not even LARPing.
It's your fault for singing the song!
His name's not Riker, either.
Guys, let's bring it back.
He's just on the holodeck.
Guys.
No, it's Riker LARPing!
Guys, let's bring it back.
On deck.
What I don't remember, though, is they ever gave it a different theme song. I remember it
was da, 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 da.
No, we're moving past that. Da, we're moving past da, 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 into a temple.
Cut to commercial. Cut to commercial.
Fighting the frizzies at 11.
These monks have sent some.
Wait, I don't remember a different theme song.
Tonight
I don't remember
UPN.
The song.
They had one. They had one the whole time. It was during the end credits.
I'm not talking about the end credits. You made it sound like
Calm
they changed the
yo
intro.
Tits.
No! There's one of the few things that pisses me the fuck off. Because it's because that the Enterprise failed that we wound up with the shit J.J. Abrams movies!
We're here for games. We're here for temples. Yeah. We're here for busting his ass out of a cage. Eventually.
Yeah. We're gonna break him out of the prison where the people are worshipping this god.
And not to mention the maybe not sure their vampire charm that's on me.
Looks like it's starting to weaken, maybe. I don't know.
Okay. You reach the temple doors, and the... Sorry. Last second for giggles.
Take a breather.
Be calm. Inhale, exhale. Eat pretzel.
Oh. Fuck you, Evan.
Yeah.
Shut up, Brennan.
Jarrett, looks like your time is finally here.
He's getting up.
Oh, he's getting up. Here we go. Yeah. Here we go.
Chair falls.
Don't actually
fall from
that chair. That's old.
Not that one.
We didn't think it was going to come to us this time,
Use
but it's
he's
finally happening.
He's grabbing a treasure chest.
Yeah.
Bam. And Brennan has been removed from the game. And so has his head.
Banhammer.
Which means you're all gone.
His headless body's on the ground.
Game's over.
Okay.
We win. We won.
No, we're all accomplices to murder.
Hey, guess what? You're
not me.
You're all going to jail.
We beat Uber.
We've got it on tape. We know it was him.
Yeah, we can evidence.
Guys, we beat Uber.
Yep. We can write our own ending.
He's in jail.
Okay. You reach the temple doors. Forged from wrought and cast bronze. Behind it you hear the sounding of chimes and bells, along with faint monks chanting. Aside from that, all is quiet on the mountain peak, as the wind blows gently through your hair.
Like, sound doesn't travel outside the temple. Like, you go outside, it's silent. You go inside, chanting monks.
Is the door locked or is it unlocked?
That's neat.
That's a good question.
I try the door.
It's not locked.
Alright.
I don't see a reason for the temple door to be locked.
Open a tab. Just peek in.
As the door cracks open,
A faint warmth pours through the crack into the frigid air outside. Inside, you can see candles and the occasional monk walking by. Traditional Eastern monk vibe.
What kind of Eastern monk? I mean,
that's aren't like Shaolin monk. Orange robes, shaved heads.
I all of a sudden I feel out of place.
With my
giant beard.
Yeah, they're looking at me like, you're a heretic.
Do you go to stroke your beard?
What am I doing again?
You're just sort of standing in the main antechamber of the temple. Do you go to stroke your beard?
I would if I was thinking about something.
Can I see?
Are you thinking about something?
I'm thinking about what I'm doing.
So what are you doing right now? You go to stroke your beard to find nothing there.
Oh.
Oh no!
Can I see him for you?
No.
If he's in a jail cell, I don't think we would see
him. We're not in the right room.
From the entrance.
We don't know he's there.
He said the main.
Rest in peace.
We don't know he's in there.
I know, but he said the main chamber, so I assumed that was within eyeshot.
Yeah. You know what? I just face you and say,
it's a big temple.
Wouldn't it look suspicious we try to crawl around? They're monks. We're supposed to be here. Seek their help. Why not look like we belong here?
Alright. I don't think we're gonna, just disguise ourselves as monks.
Do you want me to shave your head?
Not quite like that.
We haven't even seen what the monks look
as guests. Don't take me that literally.
They're bald with it with orange... He has.
Fine.
What do I have?
They're bald with it with orange getup.
Yeah.
Okay.
Everyone's none of you are wearing orange.
Let me revise my statement. Let us look like we belong here as guests, rather than monks.
How do you propose you guys do that?
Enter in casually, not trying to sneak around, look like we're out to steal something.
Alright.
So, I open the door all the way.
Were there any signs cracked open coming on the way here or in front of the temple?
No.
No, welcome mat or anything?
Nope.
Please wipe your home, sweet home?
Nope.
Or an info kiosk or something?
No!
Is there a tour guide?
That's not how ancient temples work.
This is a monastery.
Is there one of those information desks with the
even temples today have, an info kiosk, and this is a modern country, so...
Well, it's modern-esque, but...
It's about 1,000 years ago modern.
I don't know. We don't know. This is anachronistic hubbub.
What year is it?
Anachronistic
mishmash.
It's
more like 100 years ago modern, if anything.
Yeah.
It's more like... 70 years ago, modern. Hey, planes and stuff.
You're applying Earth logic into a setting that's an anachronistic clusterfuck of multiple errors mashed into one.
Do they have an information desk?
No!
Alright, there's your answer.
We can clearly see inside that I opened the door all the way.
We opened the door and ask, excuse me, do you guys have an information desk?
No. Do you say that?
No.
Well, the door is open. I'm sure one of them
is
looking at us.
Do you say that?
No.
Okay.
Does someone come up to greet us?
No. One or two monks look over towards you. The rest are on the floor in meditative positions.
I'm going to look for someone who looks like they're not meditating, who looks like they have some power or some looks knowledgeable or looks different than the rest. With a passive perception of...
He's looking for an elite.
I'm sure anyone there could give us information.
A passive of 17, I discern nothing, right? Okay. They all look very...
They all look the same. All
right.
Literally as
everyone.
Okay,
new question. Who's not in prayer or meditation?
Two people. One is not in orange, and another one is a woman wandering around the antechamber.
I thought you said they're all in orange.
Well, he was kind of obscured by the taller woman.
Is the woman... in their uniform.
Yes.
What's the guy wearing?
The non-orange person.
I'm assuming he's talking about Jer.
Oh. No, you don't recognize him.
Okay.
My most discerning, is he blindfolded?
He's completely bald?
My most discerning feature...
Does he have lights coming out of his eyes?
He has his back turned to you.
Okay.
Oh.
But
he looks like a dwarf.
So he's not in prison.
Okay.
We would recognize his
ghetto. But people around here are from every single race.
All right, that's
There's even
fair.
Some orcs around here.
We would recognize his get-up unless they change his uniform.
He's not dressed in orange, then.
No, he is not.
All right, I'm going to assume, this person must be of significant rank if they're not wearing the same uniform. I'm going to ask them a question about this place.
When you enter the antechamber, you notice in the back wall a human male seated in a meditative position, a giant statue with eyes that look like his.
They stole your power.
I was like, huh.
No, it's not a it's not a person. It's a statue.
Oh, a statue.
Like, and the eyes are like,
sort of like the giant Buddhas from temples.
I'm just trying to put two and two together. Yeah. I think I figured out in character, but
yeah,
just like boop history. 10.
No.
It was like, huh. He has similar eyes to the statue.
Hey, that looks
That's
like
weird.
That guy we know.
You say that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Does...
I was like, hold on, I'm going to ask a few questions.
Does the lady look like the person that jacked Jer?
No.
You wouldn't know that?
Yeah, we would, because we've seen her.
She'd look different if
no,
it was a
vampire.
No,
he's talking about the vampire chick.
She'd look different. She wouldn't look like a vampire.
Jer...
Yes.
Time to roll a wisdom save.
Wisdom I'm dead.
Apparently you gave him advantage before because he's had so much.
Love.
Does he still have that?
No. Well, actually, yeah, he does.
Advantage.
I think, yeah.
There
I,
you go.
I think, no.
Oh, you don't trust my d20.
I trust only my own, thank you.
Let's see.
You rolled
that
one twice.
Set you gave me. Because it borked on you.
Oh, you are in trouble. My dice are happy.
And your first roll is an 8.
Plus?
That tolls a 17.
Great!
That tolls a 17.
Which is apparently has plus 9 for some reason.
What? How did
Wisdom save, right?
Yeah.
19, 17.
Yep.
How does...
One more.
Wisdom.
Jeez.
See if you're rolling higher.
Oh, he's right. It is plus 9. That's bonkers.
Nice.
That's better.
23.
23.
Okay. Suddenly, the light returns to the world around you. You feel like a great fog has been lifted from your head, and you suddenly question, what the fuck are you doing here?
Where's my beard?
Do you shout this as I move my way toward you?
No.
I don't think you would notice that right away. When
no, this is as you're approaching him.
So
how does he, what is his current actions as we're approaching him?
May I roll a perception check to
stroke your beard?
To detect him.
We're not making any effort to be quiet.
We're not trying to be.
They're not making any effort, dude.
Hide.
We're casually moving toward you.
They're acting natural.
Yeah, your back is turned toward us. You hear people casually moving toward you and chatting idly. As someone says, hey, he has the eyes of the guy we know.
I would imagine coming out of haze, you'd be like, whoa, what's going on? And you'd look around.
What the hell am I doing here?
Then you'd, like, notice us.
I put my hand to my forehead as if suddenly having a headache.
Well, the man you're approaching leans over. Hand in it.
Sir,
head in
are
hand.
You okay?
Wait. That sounds familiar. I turn around. Voice.
Do you see Nashir standing over your shoulder.
Do I recognize him?
You recognize the eyes.
You'd recognize the structure of the face.
What is
it's obscured by facial hair.
Well, the beard doesn't like cover the whole face.
There's still
roll
some sort
like,
of check to realize.
You know what?
Like, no sure. beard, no
when
hair.
When I watched Civil War, I had a problem realizing it was Tony Stark without the little goatee thing.
Yep.
You know what? Yeah, that's a good point. Like subtle differences.
I think that was
can make
pretty
a
obvious.
Person.
That was, yeah.
And so you will go with insight for this one.
That's still going to be 15.
He has the same eyes. No one else you know has the same eyes.
It just changed that it's like, you're not. Are you?
Well, what's going on?
Nashir? What? Sorry.
Yes.
That is Nashir.
Okay.
Wait, what's your character's name again?
Emrin.
Emrin?
Is that you, Emrin?
What happened? I thought last thing I remember was we were...
You're asking what us
was
what
last,
happened. What happened to you?
The last thing I remember... I was on the plane, right? Yeah. Last thing I remember was that we were on the plane. What happened?
Apparently you joined this covenant here. I knew you were a holy man, but I didn't know that this is who you revered.
The plane took a bit of a shortcut to the ground.
I believe your friend tried to crash us.
How'd you get here?
I've...
Insight.
He doesn't remember.
Wouldn't that be history?
No.
Insight on myself?
On yourself.
Okay.
Okay.
I don't think an insight would be for recalling. History is for recalling.
Yeah.
Insight is not
24.
Okay. You've been dominated for the better part of the last 2 days.
2 days.
2 days. You were not just dominated, you were enthralled.
Like, okay, as a player I know that, but as a character, do I, like...
You realize your brain's been messed with.
You were mind controlled.
I feel like my mind has not been my own.
Yes, it's been the vampire princesses.
You now, don't know. Oh, you would know that. You know that. You weren't paying attention.
Well, we knew that she took him, so...
He was acting unnatural. I could have put two and two together in that amount of time. To be fair, I did, I think, last session. Or the one before.
Actually, yeah, we were with him for a while.
I was like, you know what? I'm going to investigate because something fishy's up. And that's when...
you never finished that thought, though.
Wasn't that a fun moment?
Yeah.
And it was like, you know what? I think something's up. I'm going to check this out. Wait, oh no! She's on to me.
Apparently it's not so easy escaping from a falling plane.
Yes, this plane craft.
Oh, and by the way,
not so easy escaping while keeping everyone alive.
A bit of back thing plane. when you went up to the temple doors, you noticed a giant like crater thing in front of the door.
Another crater?
Crater.
A human a man sized crater.
A Jeremy sized crater.
a dwarf sized crater.
Shaped. Oh. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I would imagine it would be a splat rather than him being alive if that was the case.
Well, I did come down on that one dragon like a meteor that one time.
Yeah. Oh, you came down on that dragon.
You came in like a wrecking ball.
Yeah. And there go those caps.
Yeah, pick up the caps.
Yeah, Evan, pick up the cap I just threw at you.
You're like surviving the apocalypse now. You ain't got to buy any water.
I'm holding on to my bottle caps.
Yeah, that's water trade right there.
You're dumb. You're all dumb. Stop being dumb.
See, screw you. I'm putting money on Redding's NCR print money. That's the future. Not bottle caps.
Anyway.
Okay.
I lost my train of thought.
He just appeared in front of you. You're bald. You have no beard, and your mind has been taken over for the better part of the last 2 days.
Despite being aghast by your appearance, I mentioned the vampire, and you probably just have war flashbacks.
I don't think by now he realizes.
Not so much. I still don't remember what happened while I was not myself.
To be honest, we couldn't tell you.
You followed her. I couldn't tell you what else happened because I wasn't with you the whole time, but
we were kind of separated until just now.
Yes.
All right.
What happened to your beard?
And then he realizes and makes a scene.
He's going to start crying. It's like Samson. You're not going to be able to do any of your skills without a beard.
Right.
He lost his power.
I go into shock and fall down.
Do you?
He's dead.
Sure, why not?
Okay.
You killed him.
Constitution save.
The shock of losing his beard was too much to take.
He is a dwarf.
Uh-oh. That's a two.
Great.
That's a five.
Oh, no.
What and my beard gave me power. Why would...
What have you people done to him?
System shock rules?
We have done nothing. We have merely shown him one of his kind, apparently.
What about his beard? Have you done
anything? Well, that's kind of a thing here.
What?
It's no tradition.
Sure. Are there...
Just to shave people?
Did they shave their eyebrows, too?
Shows a detachment with the material world. A disregard for appearances. So that one might obtain true enlightenment.
Yeah, but don't you ask them if they'd like this first? You just do
all
it?
Who must enter the temple must have no facial hair or hair.
They have no eyebrows.
Have we been trimmed while we weren't looking?
We would know this. I'm
in armor. Good luck getting to anything under that.
Could be magic trimmers.
Next time you see me, I'm probably gonna have like a full helmet, like.
Lord Humongous Helmet, like how his face is burned off, just fuses like the
hockey mask. Brennan, what's your passive perception?
17 for me.
My passive perception is 15.
You got no hair.
You got no hair, buddy. Yours is 17?
Yes.
You got no hair, buddy.
Oh. How did they do this?
Okay.
Because I wear so many wigs all the time, I naturally shave it off.
But I've been wearing my hat the whole time.
And armor.
They're good, like, these are good monks.
Would they get rid of our eyebrows, too, or something?
Nope, just your hair and facial hair.
Well, I'm like an elf. I wouldn't really have facial hair anyways.
You could if you wanted.
It would just take decades. Really, it's not really an elf thing.
When was the last time you shaved?
Could be if you wanted. Be alien.
Either way, at least now you've been shaving since the last time.
Yeah.
It's been a couple weeks since you've been in front of the mirror.
Probably.
And then the monk lady looks at you again and goes, all must be bald.
It's the hair empire.
Oh,
this is
a... No! Stop!
This is objection!
We're going into Bobobo here.
Shut up!
You know what? I'm fine with this, because now I can empower the sun using my chrome dome.
Just aim it.
It's like an anti-hair field or something.
It's like Captain Hair from Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Wow. You start futzing around under your armor, and you're going like, wait, what? What? What?
Ah.
What? What? What?
Just this, like, ah.
The first question is what. The second question is why. Better question is how.
I minor illusion my hair back.
It doesn't work.
It doesn't work.
I just keep doing it.
Doesn't work.
It looks like it's about to work, and then it just fizzles out.
Is it just the hair and the face?
Alright. Your eyebrows are fine, if that's what you're wondering.
Right. I just shrug and don't care.
Okay. Welcome to the Temple of Enlightenment. How may I be of assistance?
You're just continuing on the ground.
A barber shop.
We're here to look into some concerns. Like, for example, the ruler... A legion of vampires. I don't know if the latter means anything to you. Surely the former does.
Brian, we don't know where their allegiances lie.
We have no allegiance.
I didn't say that out loud. I'm just talking to Brian specifically.
Okay, how does he react to me talking about looking into some information regarding the ruler as well as the legion of vampires? That's not any sort of bias.
Certainly. If you would come with me to the scrying chamber.
Insight. Because I didn't hear anything from you or you because it happened out of character. Well, I'm apparently quite insightful on that statement. Do I sense any bias or sort of...
No, as a matter of fact, she means exactly what she says.
Okay. I just usher them along saying, we have little to worry. Most likely.
I insight the monk's statement as well.
That's a 9.
You're not going to get any more than he did.
Trust me on this.
He rolled better than me.
I'll just say trust me on this. I pondered on her statement. I think we're in good shape.
Have you people ever thought of opening a barbershop? Pretty good work, pretty quickly.
The trimming is free to all who walk through the doors. And compulsory.
Huh. Probably should have put a warning outside the door.
Or maybe to be fair,
magical shaving hair. If you walk through here.
To be fair, it will be far less amusing that way.
They do have a sense of humor.
Yes. You just hear subtle ha ha coming from the meditation chambers.
Onward to the scrying room.
What are you gonna do about him? He's still on the floor.
I'm gonna look to him.
You know what? I'm gonna try to
seems a lot more detrimental to the door than it does.
I'm gonna try to prop him up.
I'm just gonna slap him awake.
As I prop him on his feet.
17 slap to wake up.
I'm going to take 10 for 13 to try to just prop on his feet. While he just goes, slap.
You put him on his feet, he'll just fall over if he's still sleeping.
Like do you wake up?
Do I?
So, do you, well, roll yourself a constitution.
All right. Well, you're on your feet, and I'm propping you up, so...
That's a 5 on the dice, and,
that's a 9.
Okay.
No.
Vial of lake water.
No, I know. Acid splash.
Nope.
No.
Water. Vial of wake water. That's a nasty awakening.
Okay. Roll a constitution
check. Right on your chrome dome.
Advantage.
Advantage, because of the lake water.
It's kind of cold.
Great.
Great.
Okay.
Oh!
You're like, Roll a wisdom save.
Is this for what? Save versus flashbacks?
Why would he wisdom
save?
Save.
Yeah. Wisdom swave.
Wisdom swave.
What was that? Did you roll?
25.
You're fine.
Listen.
Better?
You're a bit disabled right now, but it's okay. We still think you as a friend. And I know dwarves can be a bit touchy about the subject, but you've lost your manhood.
Not necessarily. He's one with the sun. Perhaps he can channel it better through pointing to the top of his head. No hair.
Do we see any other dwarves in this place?
Nah, a few.
Like a flash of light.
You heard, you see a few other dwarves, also shaven.
After a flat, like a flash of light, I speed my way to
Where can I go to?
I have armor, shiny armor. You can just look at that. Instant mirror.
Where can I go to get something to cover my face?
Put a helmet on.
Cloth.
A scarf?
Here.
Sure.
Here. Some of the monks have scarves.
I just
rip some of his tunic off or something.
Yeah.
I don't have the tunic, I have to cover this. I'm just in armor.
I've grown this out since cloth. I was a wee lad.
You know what?
He's lost his manhood.
After a sec. Just tear some off the bag. Cloth. To cover you.
Now he looks like a train robber. Just gotta get him like a big wide brimmed hat now.
Or like one of the olden style stereotypical Japanese bandits.
I don't know what that means, but I'll go with it.
Alright. I usher you onward.
You follow the monk lady into the
Yep. Okay. I presume everyone else does. Right?
All this being said, Emrin thinks that
I'll kind of hang back a little bit with him, trying to reassure him that everything will be okay.
Yeah, I'm trying to help
him. It won't be.
All this being said, Emrin says to him, like, says non-vocally to himself.
Mm. Thinking in his head?
There was that statue in the main hall that looked a lot like me. This must be destiny.
Is it a dwarf statue?
And it must be true, because it rhymes.
It's a human. He said it was a human statue. But it had no ass.
Remember this, Jeremy, and remember this very well. My particular philosophy on storytelling is very straightforward. There are no such thing as coincidences, and there is no such thing as destiny. Or prophecies.
There are red herrings.
Yes. Like the darkness.
I hate you so much about that.
Onward.
Not only did you get fooled by the blindfold, but now you have no beard.
All right, onwards to that
I can't wait. Emrin cannot wait to get out of here so he can regrow his beard.
Over the next few decades.
You know what? Magical steroids.
You're not,
pump them
you're not wrong. You're not wrong.
Magical hair solution.
That's right.
Just pour some on his face.
I got a plan. It's okay.
It'll be great.
What? Wigs.
I got a plan. It's okay. Don't worry.
First What's your plan?
Yeah.
To help him.
So you enter the later ushers you into a room that is protected by a
secret... the ladle? What?
He said lady.
I heard ladle. Sorry.
Brian, you're drunk.
No, just have bad hearing.
Okay. There's a door secured beneath the cloak of the statue.
Oh.
Behind it, you find a chamber of complete darkness. Aside from a
single... Do we have blindfolds?
Shut up. Aside from a silver basin in a large one in the middle of the chamber.
Is the basin lit up?
You hear chanting from all around the room.
Like temple chanting.
Yeah, monks chanting.
Do we see monks all around the room?
It's dark.
Dark vision.
It's dark.
You don't see anything.
Super dark vision.
Is it magical darkness?
I don't know.
Arcana.
Is it?
No.
Arcana. I'm asking you because I have dark vision.
Arcana to aid.
Fine.
Just do it.
Arcana check.
You know what?
Net 20.
I don't even need to aid you. I crit.
Yeah,
so.
You got it.
It's magical darkness.
Yep. Okay, cool. 22. That's magical darkness.
What is this place? I say to
cloaked in something.
The Chamber of Light.
Ah. It's awfully dark.
Yeah.
There's not a whole lot of light in here.
Well, it's right there in that thing you can see. You said there was a big hole or something, right?
I'm going to just look toward the monk. Do the eyes have anything to do with this?
You look towards the monk in the dark room.
Or in the general direction of the monk lady. Do the eyes have anything to do with this?
This is the room where our most enlightened monks cast their eyes towards the sacred basin, in hopes to learn more of the world around us, and possibly, according to legend, worlds beyond.
So this is the scrying chamber where they spy on people.
Worlds beyond.
That's putting it rather harshly.
However, really. Worlds beyond have not been seen for quite some time.
Try thousands, as I've heard.
Couple thousand. She smiles, not wryly, though you can't see it in the darkness.
She's actually making faces. Just sticking her tongue out, flipping you off.
And she's just like,
can't tell.
Just eyes bulging open and silly smiles, doing a little dance.
I'll ask her plainly.
Bring it back.
So, this basin is clearly the tool for scrying. How do we use it?
You must open your eyes.
Well, there you go. That's easy enough.
It's not a very plain... Who wants to dump
That's
their head?
That's the only instructions given to any monk.
I'll try.
He seems the most worthy.
Ow.
The dwarf wishes to dunk his head.
Careful in the darkness.
Lady... Did I get her name?
No.
She's just lady.
Lady monk, you must... Did you hurt yourself? I think I heard you trip over something.
No. That was merely one of the trainees doing exercises in the other room. Worry not.
Right? I just sort of usher you along. You barely see the
can I insight on that?
Sure.
That's 25.
She kicked over a piece of equipment on the ground, probably.
I'm pleased with that.
You're going to stick your head in the basin or something?
Yeah. I will stick my head in the basin or something.
Well, he's clean, so.
It feels cool and refreshing.
Is it water in the basin?
It feels cool and refreshing.
Alright.
I'm going to approach the basin that his head's currently in.
Okay, I take my head out.
Look at what he's doing.
Is it wet?
You're wet.
You know what?
Something.
I have an idea. I'm going to just grab the basin, try to focus, and try to attune it as if it were a magic item.
You're going to steal the basin from everyone?
Just try to treat it like an item and just like, okay, my hand's on the basin. I'm going to try to attune it and focus with, what's the check for it? I think just intelligence.
Yeah, I just
attuning is like something that goes over time.
I just stare into the basin.
It's shiny.
Or I look into it and try to think, maybe it's a magic item. I'll try to attune it.
Nope.
I look in the basin. Is the liquid clear like water, or does it look like something else?
It has a silvery tint to it.
Is it opaque or transparent?
Semi-transparent.
I got an idea.
Like a foggy mist.
That sword?
Wasn't it you?
You're the one who has the sword.
Okay, I'll take that sword out then. I'm gonna see if I can remove the eye from the little catch.
I want to try that.
It's very firmly in there.
I'll try to put the hilt into the wall.
I have an idea.
Nothing happens.
You have an eye? Let the eye stare into it. I looked at my eye patch and look as well toward the water. Not directly so I see myself, but just so it reflects on the water like I don't know.
Very creative, but nothing happens.
Oh.
I dealt the eye into the water. The hilt of the sword.
Nope.
I ask Azeloth and Fear what they tell me about this artifact.
That's a little too specific.
That's
not specific enough.
How do we use this?
Us demon kind don't really do so well with enlightenment puzzles.
I mean, do you know what this is?
This grind chamber.
Very
powerful one.
Can I do some sort of wisdom check on the basin?
Yes, you may.
Well, check or save?
Check.
24.
Yes. It's exuding a very strong arcane presence. However, it's not evil nor good.
That's it.
Alright, you know what?
I'm going to try thinking about seeing if it works by focusing on the person. So I'm going to think about the revenant. See if somehow, maybe, see something.
Nothing happens.
I am going to ask the monk.
She's gone. And the door's closed behind her.
Well,
I'm going to ask the monks around the room chanting.
You don't know where they are. Silent.
Has anyone here actually tried drinking out of this?
They continue chanting.
I wouldn't do that.
I use my Warhammer of Searing Smite, the Sun Hammer.
Yeah.
And shine light into the basin.
The light reflects off the liquid in the basin. It's a very beautiful effect. But you can't see it because you're in total darkness.
All right, I'm gonna cast light.
But we're able to see the area around the basin, though.
Yes,
aren't we?
You can see the basin. That's it.
I'm gonna cast light on the basin itself.
Nope.
Ding.
It just glows a little.
Yep.
All right, I detract it.
If I splash some of the water outside of the basin, does that also glow?
It does not.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, when you splash it, it creates a fizzling sound of some kind.
I'm going to take some water in my hands, sort of let it drip, and just sort of look in the water in my palms, anything besides my hands I see in the water.
You don't see anything because you've removed it from the basin, and now you see darkness.
And okay, it drips back into the basin. Anything?
You see a rippling effect in the liquid.
Okay.
So it has to do with the basin itself.
I am going.
What kind of material is the basin made of?
What?
Probably stone.
It's like a big carved stone basin with a small divot in the very bottom of it. It looks like a hole that goes straight down.
Really?
So like
probably like a well that brings water up.
Or a bird bath.
With a sun hammer.
Oh.
Gross. Do you tell me about this?
Yes, hey, there's a hole right there.
Can I investigate the hole?
It's a hole. It is indeed a hole.
Investigate. Stick something in that hole?
I wish to stick my sun hammer into that hole.
Oh, my.
Oh, baby. Unfortunately, the width of the pole is a little too wide for the hole.
I'm going to assume if you plug in the hole, it would stop water from flowing into the basin.
I stick my finger into the hole.
The boy who stuck his finger into a dam.
This is a great puzzle. I love you guys.
I'm going to hold on to the basin.
Yes.
And then I'm going to make an intelligence check. And I'm going to, think about fear.
What kind of thoughts are you having about her?
Confusing ones.
Like, where is fear? Or can I see what she's up to, etc.?
What's she wearing?
What are you wearing?
Durr!
After a bit, I try again.
That's like 10 minutes.
Durr!
Oh!
He's 20 minutes doing that. He's basically stuck for 20 minutes trying nothing.
You fool!
Alright, I'm going to try surveying over Mr. Emperor himself, see what he's doing with a similar check. I'm going to sink 20 minutes by doing two checks.
Okay.
First one, 10 minutes.
That's a six.
Is that cocked or is that a six?
That's not cocked.
That's a six. Hi. 19.
Nothing! You see nothing!
So we waste 20 minutes doing that, okay?
And
what are you clowns doing?
And you do too.
Yeah, I know. I said both of us can be
for 20 minutes.
What do you do for 20 minutes?
This is the best thing ever. I love you guys, but you're all way too smart to not be figuring this out.
I mean, you're giving us, like, no hints.
I gave you the biggest hint possible in the very beginning of this puzzle.
The magic of darkness around us.
No.
I close my eyes while looking at the basin.
Ta-da! After 20 minutes.
What do I see?
What do you wish to see?
I'm thinking about fear.
You see her seated around a small square table. Colonel Bellator, the thief boys, a massive pile of chips in the center of the table. And strangely enough, Bellator and the thief boys are all almost completely naked.
They're all dicking about at that bar playing poker.
Yeah. That's
great. No, you hear the sloshing of water around them.
Oh, they're on the boat.
What makes you think that?
Because I just got a vision of fear.
How so?
I'm going to think about the, close my eyes and think about the...
Have you communicated
the,
this?
The iron guy.
I'm trying.
I communicate that they're dicking about. I didn't communicate what I see.
He's struggling greatly with a design on the far wall of his little cargo bay in the ship.
You know what? I see you close your eyes and you say the vision. So
I'm not sure you can see me close my eyes.
Wait. Static?
Yep.
I'm going to try moving my head.
How did you know to close your eyes? You can't see him do it.
What?
I don't know.
How do you know?
I'm not doing anything else.
I mean, it took 20 minutes and we're blinking anyway.
I yawn at one point and realize, that's weird.
Plus, he dunked his head in. He would have closed his eyes when he did that.
Not necessarily. He wouldn't exactly have to. Like, it's like, well, I'm going to look into the depths of it. Ah! Eyes wide open. I close my eyes. Mm-hmm. Instead of trying to focus on anything, I try and focus on nothing, as if meditating.
Then you'd probably see nothing.
Hmm.
See, I actually didn't expect any one of you to actually say that.
Oh.
There's
a thing.
Especially not from Jeremy. Good job.
to focus on nothing.
You place yourself into a meditative position on the ground, close your eyes, and start thinking about the vastness of the universe.
So this basin isn't like a fountain or anything. It's like a... divot.
There's an antechamber around you with
so it's like a divot or something.
Yes.
Okay.
So it's not like a bird bath kind of thing?
No.
I thought it was.
I thought it was, too.
It's, you actually stand in front of the basin. Like, it's at foot level.
Okay. That... yeah,
this whole time I was thinking more like waist level with, like, a...
No, something it's, about it's foot level recessed into the floor.
Okay. So it's like a small bath.
Yes. As you start thinking,
pool party.
you begin to hear song in your head. The same song that's being chanted by the monks in the background.
Right.
Before you realize it, your mouth starts. He starts making the same noises,
like absentmindedly.
So he's chanting.
Jer, I need to see you outside.
Oh,
and I need you to bring something to take notes with.
So, did you communicate that paper? You closed your eyes to do it?
What?
No, I didn't. Because I might have thought maybe it was a combination.
Nah, I got a note. I got the note up in here. I mean,
I'm gonna go grab another drink.
Okay.
You two keep rambling.
I will.
Pause.
Let me grab.
Fine. Pause. Jeez.
This seems like the moment where we would do this.
It's very sour. You're going to find the truth about yourself, Jeremy. Congratulations.
Yeah, I'm not your failure. Let's unhit pause. Okay.
It was pause. I didn't hit stop.
Okay.
Great.
Yeah, no, I didn't hit stop. That's silly.
Why would anyone hit stop? That makes no sense.
Because it's clean. Hitting the space bar is easier.
All right.
And Jer, and it's one last thing. When you open your eyes, as if illuminated by a bright light, you see the chamber. Circular seating, monks on either benches to the left to the left or right
of you. I was under the assumption that they were just like on their knees and hands and knees. Like,
no,
just...
there's it's raised. They're sort of like a
theater,
like a Roman amphitheater.
Oh, okay.
All like around. The Colosseum type thing?
Kind of, where not it's quite. Different, where there's circular rows of benches.
Okay.
And there's 100 or so monks inside this room. But you can see as bright as day. You guys can't see anything.
So all right. I have been enlightened.
But you also, you can't see what he sees, but you can see his eyes.
So his eyes are...
Like, normally, bright. Like, normally they're like... Yeah, like glowing yellowish.
Now something. They're more of a silver color.
What were his eyes glowing when we found him?
Earlier? Yes.
Okay.
And as you gaze around the room, more and more and more sets of eyes start appearing.
They're opening their eyes.
All of the monks in this room have their eyes. Glowing silver.
All right.
Well, I imagine glowing everyone here is enlightened.
Well, hold on.
Not
if,
quite.
If
we're
my
not, we're
eyes
bleeps.
Were glowing golden, and now
the
they're glowing
people
silver.
Who are more
maybe there's like a certain
way
like
to the area.
Maybe there's like a like something different about mine.
You've been upgraded.
you know what I do? Since I thought about fear and I saw the vision, I'm gonna think about this room.
Nothing.
You
else,
see but. Nothing. All right. I'm going to think about Mr. Gnomish Emperor himself as I close my eyes and just sort of think about it. Well.
Did you... Wait, hold on. Why are you closing your eyes? Why are you closing your
he
eyes?
He never communicated that.
He never communicated that. And you can't see shit!
Alright. But I did, like, get this thing to work, so...
But you didn't say anything.
Yeah, why didn't you say anything?
Guys, you...
Guys, grab onto the basin, and then...
You don't need to grab the basin.
Yeah,
no, you don't know that.
So I'm telling them what I've done.
Grab the basin. Okay.
Hold on to the basin, have your hand in the water.
Well, to be fair... You,
think about something,
you guys,
close your eyes.
You guys did...
That's what I went through, so that's what I would communicate to them.
Okay.
You guys did notice, though, like, by the time you explain this,
doing your thing.
And yeah. As the eyes start appearing, the chanting grows louder.
All right.
And it feels as if the whole chamber is shaking in response to, I don't know, a resonant frequency of some kind.
So in reaction, I try just surveying the Emperor guy. What he said, because now I have
like
reason
med-
to try
you
that.
You see him talking to what looks to be a farmer of some kind.
No discernible thing about the farmer?
Nope. The farmer walks up to him, falls to his knees, and starts begging for something. The emperor sits upon the throne with his hand.
So he's
facing his hand.
Yeah.
Strokes his tiny bit of gnomish facial hair at the end of his chin.
Little goatee.
He points to the guards, points to him, then points to a window.
The
farmer gets picked up by the guard.
I try to sever the vision.
And then thrown out the window.
I try to sever the vision.
Too late.
I'm going to think about myself.
He then points to another guard, points to the window, and starts giggling. The second guard throws himself out the window.
And that's where I stop.
Yep.
Nope.
I'm going to think about myself.
You see an asshole.
It hurts your brain. because you see yourself seated in the chamber, thinking about the basin, thinking about yourself. Nope.
The people we think about, we're not sitting there.
I'm stuck in an infinite loop.
Too deep. You've gone too deep.
A whole part about this type of enlightenment is to detach from the self. Focusing on the self is the exact opposite of what you're supposed to be doing.
It hurts. Mm. All right, I'm going to try to think about life and death in balance. Trying again.
That was another concept that would have worked. But he doesn't see everything you did. You see a scale. Scales. A set of scales. Yep. Like justice scales.
Mm-hmm.
Lying on the ground next to a smoldering building. The image then pans out, and it's unmistakable.
Did you give him the same... Does he get the same details that
not
I got?
Not all of them.
I just get the intro of Fallout.
You see the ruins of the Thrysterian capital. The scales sit resting on the ground. You then see a black stone in the middle of a stone quarry in the middle of the woods. Strangely enough, insight from you. And insight from you.
He was pointing at Brian and Jer.
Okay.
Insight 22.
Might, like, for the sake of podcast, might be better.
Yeah.
I've said it like a thousand times. Address my names, and you guys still don't bother.
Yes. I forget we don't have a camera.
Yeah. 21.
Okay. You passed by this quarry once before on your way to that gold mine of yours.
I forget, is this a literal gold mine or a...
Yeah.
The yes. one we made. The one we converted.
First found fear.
Where we, yeah.
Yeah, where we converted into a gold mine.
I must have...
Oh, wait, that was right before Jeremy's character came back.
It might have been.
So you don't know what it means, probably.
Ida, what did you roll?
Andrew's I rolled 22.
Okay. Same thing.
Okay. I'm just trying to think harder about the quarry, if that does anything.
I'm trying to think of how to tell these guys I know what we're looking for without sounding creepy.
While they've been doing that,
I could talk to you and
what
say,
what I've been doing is thinking
do you know
about
of a quarry
the different members of my race that are still alive, and just seeing what they're up to individually.
You
so
see
probably
different...
takes me a while to get
yeah,
through
it does
all
see, take you a little while to get going, but it takes about the same amount of time that these guys took to figure everything out.
Because there's so little left.
Yep. You see different members of your race, male, female...
Doing what they love.
Doing what they love, treating the wounded. But every single vision ends the same way. Right. It ends with a hawk flying through the window of wherever they are, or approaching them in the middle of a field... with a note attached to it. And then they all start setting off in a certain direction.
Okay.
I'm gonna...
Even the Revenant?
Take things a little differently.
You don't see him. What?
So, we've been thinking about people with physical forms.
Not him and I.
Oh, no.
We've been on metaphysical.
Oh, no.
Well, you have. I'm gonna think about Azaloth.
Okay.
Oh. I was thinking you were going for something else.
I thought about the Emperor. That's physical.
What you see actually kind of amuses you. You see him in his normal state, which is his normal form. Blue skin, white wings, sitting on a chair in the middle of a stark white room, just twiddling his thumbs.
And while I'm seeing this, I'll ask, Azaloth, are you able to use this... device yourself.
What?
Do I see him talking?
Yes, you do see him talking.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Wow!
Azaloth, do a jump.
What?
Just jump. Just do it. Just do it.
He flaps his wings and jumps. There, it's not like you can see me.
Well, that's where you're wrong.
I've got some
hold up your hand.
I've got some bad news for you.
Why are you making me do this? It's weird. Stop.
Ask me how many fingers you're holding up.
How many fingers am I holding up?
Three.
Stop that! Stop it! Yeah. Where are you?
Aren't you able to see where I am?
Well, I can, but I won't see this darkness and some glowing eyes. What are you doing?
I set the scrying device to you.
Why?
Did
you think it was going to be interesting?
Well, I was thinking you don't have a physical form. It might do something different.
Nice try, but existential, metaphysical... meditation and trances will not bring me back to my normal form. As a matter of fact, I'm convinced that nothing ever will.
I mean, that's not what I was trying to do, but...
Okay. Have Aslan start dancing provocatively for you.
I doubt he would do that.
I hear him say that.
Yeah.
Do I hear both of them?
No, you'll just hear him.
You just hear me saying.
Did I see images of life and death in the cycle?
Did he say anything about returning Azeloth to his form?
No, I didn't.
Okay, never mind then.
You would hear me say that's not what I was going for, but you wouldn't know what I was in reference to.
I wouldn't. Let me think.
Well, you already solved the puzzle.
I did, but well, that doesn't mean we can't find out anything else.
You're still meditating until you say something else.
I'm trying to focus on that hawk who gave the message.
Excellent. So
I think about ways to restore my beard.
Time.
Oh, you've broken your light and
all white.
And your eyes go back to normal, probably.
Are my eyes back to normal?
No. Where the hell did you put this here?
Mine's here.
Brian, is this yours?
No, this is mine.
Someone move my class. This is upsetting me.
You move it.
Now it's a bottle glass.
Don't do that.
Yes. Alright, so I...
It's going to take a lot more than a minor restoration spell.
I stopped my meditation. Or did you want to say something?
Okay, you're focusing on the hawk.
Yeah.
Herb.
You focus on one of the hawks in one of the images.
Burp, burp, burp.
And then it flies backwards, as if film was put into reverse. You see it flapping its wings in reverse, the sun going up and down in reverse. And you see it trail back towards the middle of the sea. You see a tiny little image getting bigger and bigger and bigger. A hawk then lands on an outstretched hand, with a spike coming out of it. And you see the Revenant standing there with the hawk on his hand.
Oh. All right.
Do I know the island? Is that his?
It's not an island. It's it's the ship that you guys were just on.
Ah.
Oh.
Okay. Okay. I'm gonna keep that in my soul.
I'm gonna try to focus on the quarry. Anything that I remember for it, or just anything
it's
that
a
I
big
can
hole in the ground with a giant black stone on the center.
Or focus on the rock rather. Black stone. Do I get anything
black?
Nothing.
It's as black as
night.
Nothing. Okay. It's as black as you would imagine nothing looking.
Alright, so...
Almost as if it's a hole in the center
a hole
of
in your vision.
In the universe.
Alright, so...
A hole in your vision.
Alright, so, at this moment, like, after... after realizing there's no hope...
do you come out?
Yeah, I come out.
I like how he says that to be ominous, but he's really talking about his beard.
As Emran stands up and exits his meditative stance, the basin recedes into the hole at the bottom of it.
You're saying like the liquid drains away.
A skylight opens up and illuminates the chamber. The monks' eyes returned to normal.
As do mine?
Yes, actually. Exit the chamber.
Do the visions end?
The visions end.
Okay.
I wait till they're all gone, and then...
Alright. So no more spooky black hole in the universe.
Guys, I know... I've had a certain clarity. And I proceed to tell them.
It's the clarity of the face area, because we know that. It's okay.
It might be worth coming back.
Clarity is a mind region.
See bees.
I pretend not to hear him. And
I chuckle at your joke.
There was a number of things that I saw while I was gazing outward. Outward, inward, whatever.
Inward. You were gazing in.
Inward.
Actually, you weren't gazing in any particular direction. You were just gazing at nothing.
Yeah.
Ships on fire, Tannhauser Gate, anything like that?
Stop.
Okay. Okay.
There was...
Sorry. He said he's seen some things.
Since you've been born.
The pocket watch that had, Sigil was encased in. And a sword and a stone, which I believe belonged to our old companion.
Yeah.
There was also a hand mirror, silver, and within this hand mirror there was a woman. Also, in Fortuna, in this country. An altar, and on the altar was a knife of some sort.
Hmm.
And then I also saw a castle on a lone island.
Mm-hmm.
And I also saw a stone in the quarry, and some copper scales in the Thrysterian capital. Ruins. And that's all I saw.
What about the castle on the island? What kind of castle?
I think it's the one
we've
seen.
The mirror was in the castle on the island.
Oh.
Didn't we explore
the scale?
The
I saw that in my vision.
There's more than
same
one
with
island.
The black hole in
probably
the quarry.
More than one castle on an island.
I can tell you where the quarry
is. So you're
is,
saying
this
is a different castle than the one we visited?
Yes, you would have remembered if it was the same
one.
Castle.
It's not the lakeside one.
No.
Alright, so...
I don't think we've been to the quarry.
I don't know what... I don't know what these items have to each other. But I do know that they have something of significance to...
I can assume something about two of them.
Well, we've got two of them.
I've asked.
Do we still have that pocket watch?
Yeah, it's in the sword.
You do. You well, no. The pocket watch is the.
Yeah, it's in the sword.
Who has that? Is it me?
No, the pocket watch contained the second eye of Uber that was put into the.
Oh right.
Yeah.
Didn't we put that in the sword to get it out of the rock?
Yes, you did.
So yeah, they're right here.
Yep. Wait a minute. Snickers the sword.
Yeah. You guys gave it to me for some reason. Yeah.
Snickers has one. Brian's character has the other.
Give it to you. You took it.
I guess nobody else wanted it, so I just picked up the sword.
Okay.
I think I might have some insight into the scales and the rock. I asked about a balance of life and death, and those are the visions I got. Perhaps they're symbolic of forces related to that. Death probably being the runes, and life being whatever's growing inside the quarry.
Can I insight this in any way?
Actually, I would go with a religion for this.
Oh.
What was the one you saw in this country?
It was a,
It was a knife.
On an altar.
A knife on an altar?
Maybe a sacrificial dagger?
It was a dagger on an altar in a castle.
In Fortuna.
In Fortuna.
All right, religion check.
Feeling pretty faithful.
Total 19.
Think about the pocket watch. What happened with the pocket watch? What was it? What occurred?
It was a prison for... It turned out that it had an eye of Uber.
And what else was in the watch?
The
sigil.
Sigil, the Loki of... Chaos.
And some tears.
I pointed to my shirt with Loki on it. Loki charms, because puns.
Think about it.
The player Jeremy does not understand, but maybe Emrin does.
The pocket watch was used to house Sigil. He was trapped in the pocket watch until someone willingly let him out.
Sigil is the joke god guy?
Chaos.
chaos.
My gun.
In other words, it was an artifact of the god of chaos. You were staring at nothing. It would make sense that the most powerful things to call out to you when there's nothing out there would be deific powers.
Deific.
Godly.
Basically, Uber, Sigil, and whoever that other one that disappeared was.
And maybe a handful of others, too.
Remember what he mentioned before, is that there might still be some other gods in this world, but they just don't care.
You know what? I bet that...
Or they're unable to care.
That mirror in the... That silver mirror might contain someone else.
Oh, yeah? Do you relay any information you've figured out?
I say that out loud.
Mm. And what He's about, sort of just rationalizing right now.
What about the scales and the rock? I ask specific questions. Like I said, life and death itself, those could be godly forces.
You did also say balance. Did you not?
That's correct.
It could have been a keyword.
Well, let's not too bogged down thinking right now. We could always think while we're traveling.
Yeah.
I'm more concerned with the one that's in the country we're in right now.
That should be our first stop.
That could be used.
Think about that one, the dagger. What could that symbolize?
Betrayal and assassination?
Could be that gnome king?
Someone might be using it.
Does someone hear that?
It's a bomb.
Vacate! Alright.
What do?
Run!
Run!
Leave the room!
I shout, run! Run!
As you rush out into the main chamber.
It sounds like something's being dropped upon the area.
No, you as you enter the main antechamber, the candles are gone. The room is silent. The tapestries that were once vibrant and colorful are now tattered and rotted away.
Where did all the monks go?
Ghosts?
We've been in there too long.
No.
Does he have a full set of hair again?
What year is it?
You hear the...
I have a bad feeling.
You hear what sounds like echoing chants slowly start to fade away and then vanish.
I believe this
temple... The floorboards now creak underneath your feet.
I ask again, is my beard... Does my...
No.
You know what? I say we should get out of here. This is clearly a place of phantoms.
I
raise
the eye patch.
Is the statue still there?
What?
Is the statue still there?
That we want? Yes, but it is fallen into quite disarray. And then explodes.
Huh. Great.
As we run out.
Along with the chamber behind it.
I feel like we traveled through time.
Link to the future.
Did we?
You know what? Maybe I was right.
Has
I was like,
the outside
I have
area
a feeling we've encountered
way.
Phantoms, ghosts. These people might have been long since dead.
Just explain why you wouldn't have noticed your hair getting shaved off.
Has the outside of the temple changed in any way?
As a matter of fact, it's become more decrepit. And down over the side of the mountain.
I mean,
you
not...
look down where the plane crashed. You see the plane's wreckage. But the village itself seems to have been abandoned for some time. As if everything that it has just transpired was placed here solely for the purpose that you might discover it one day.
So the village is long gone, but like the area, the trails are the same.
It's all decrepit and far less beautiful and overgrown than you would think.
So I guess we encountered helpful ghosts then. That'll explain why I could get nothing from.
I don't know.
Well, pointing to the eye patch.
I don't know if it was ghosts. They usually.
Then what?
Aren't ghosts usually hostile?
Not necessarily.
They don't have to be.
Yeah.
The Monster Manual says so, but Julian the DM says, fuck that shit.
Yep.
Casper, look at Casper.
Have you not seen the spirits of your allies not yet laid to rest?
I would imagine for their spirits have rest? Their own opinions and stuff, man.
Remember, these were the spirits of monks.
Enlightened monks.
Enlightened monks. Surely an enlightened monk, when he passes away, can maintain it, can maintain his sanity after death.
Still,
surely.
It was the ancients from Stargate. That's
since
we're
like by the stairs, I want to peek in toward the decrepit temple, like what's left of the ruins that exploded.
I will permit an arcana check from you.
Alright.
I would also wonder why did they just bomb this temple?
Was that bombing the temple?
That was a...
It's not going to explode out
I
of
might
nowhere.
Ask for help. Like, but I recognize that there's something arcane at work here, right?
We heard something falling, and then it blew up.
I was like, you're a master of the arcane, perhaps you can figure this out.
What were you arcana checking again?
Trying to figure out the magics in the temple that caused the explosion.
I attempt,
and everything.
So... 22. Arcana.
You see a glinting...
Probably just
thing
him, then.
In the center of the floor of the temple.
Do we hear something else falling?
No.
Then I go and pick up that glinting thing.
Glinting thing is a stone.
Is it a pitch black stone?
No, as a matter of fact, it's translucent and red. From the stone...
Like a ruby?
Well, not from the stones.
It's
kind
fire
of,
stone.
Kind of.
It can evolve your...
But it... He's not completely off. You see what looks to be almost like a candle flame coming from the center
it's
of the
It's
the
flame
red
of
gem.
Humanity. Keep it for your humanity.
I will ask Azla. Did you realize that everyone here was a spirit?
Yeah, I just decided
He's
to
quiet.
Keep it to myself.
He stays quiet.
I call out.
You can tell me. We're kind of working together. Might as well not keep things in.
Strangely enough, he feels as if he can't hear you right now.
I put down the rock for a second and ask him.
Still nothing.
I ask out. I call out for... Sigil, if this is your doing, give us if this is your doing, give us a sign.
Nothing.
Perhaps this
Perhaps,
is a dagger.
Maybe, at some point, someone or something gazed into the future and saw what was going to happen. Knew you would be here at this point in time, and left this stuff behind.
I'm still trying to...
So it is
the
ancients from Stargate,
I guess.
Yeah.
Something similar.
So we saw a vision from the past projected for us.
I don't
think...
That's
a ZPM you just found on the ground. Good job.
I don't think this is the temple...
We got all this energy now.
I don't think this is the temple of time.
It has a light flame in the center of it.
I'll do another arcana check. What kind of magic is this rock?
And then there's Twilight 15. Princess.
15.
Oh, that was great. Restoring the temple.
15 is still a doable check.
Strong magic.
So it doesn't have a type to it, then.
You could pass it to me and have a shot at it. I could try.
What do you see
Guys,
out of this?
I just stare into it. I discern anything from looking at it. With the eye of a spooky swirly.
Nothing.
Alright, I'm going to try to study it.
No, you... Alright.
Actually, you know what? No, keep the eye patch up.
Okay, sure.
What do you roll?
My roll was 15.
You hear a woman shriek.
From where?
The
stone?
From the, it's as if it's being emitted by the stone. You hear a shriek followed by an explosion.
I just look baffled as I lower my eye patch.
Slowly.
Yes. The stone mimicked the sound of a woman screaming before an explosion happened. Probably similar to the one we witnessed.
Well, there was just an explosion.
Yes. But it was a different scream, a voice I haven't heard before.
I want to go back into the temple and try and see if I can find anything worth value. Like to...
You're welcome to try.
Whether to us or to... Other to us or our quest or
I'm going to join
anything.
Him. I want to see if I can find a little piece of
you
that
Sure.
Like, and if not, then I would like to at least find some sort of memento to.
I'm going to try to
the monks themselves.
Focus on the stone while exploring the temple runes. Just see if I can discern anything or find anything.
Are you going to explore when you're focused?
What kind of check is this? Perception?
Investigation.
Okay. Same for me, because I'm focusing on the stone and trying to explore, discern anything from it.
This is 16.
Okay. Rooting around in the dust, very thick dust, as if this place has been abandoned for some time.
Wouldn't the explosion kind of set it all off? In a way?
Strangely enough, that the statue, the pieces that were flung off by the explosion, look as if they've been resting on the temple floor for some time.
Weird.
Alright. I have a feeling that my vision was from the past.
So 25.
And that the explosion never happened in our timeline, but in the past as well. That someone caused this to happen.
Arcana check. Have we moved through time? 26.
No.
Okay.
We'll start with the highest roll, a 25. Rooting around, you find some burnt cloths, some bones in some places, but bones that have highly degraded.
Mm-hmm.
They've been here a very, 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 very long time.
Ah, interesting thing you can
find. You notice from one of the piles of dust, you see a glinting piece of gold.
Alright.
And the gold, it's a medallion with a scorpion inscribed on it. But it's a clasp. Right. As if for a robe.
Hmm.
Do I find anything with my 16?
You find a smaller clasp. Not as ornate.
And I investigate with a total of 19 to try to see if I can discern or I might think the scream and explosion from the stone might have emitted from.
You're starting to piece things together. The fact that the monk lady disappeared when she let you into the scrying chamber.
She was killed by something.
The fact that there was an explosion that filed you out of the room when you were done with your visions. The fact that this place appears to have been abandoned for a very, very long time,
including the town nearby.
Clearly, the person or thing that had planned for you to be here is no longer of this world.
Whoever placed this vision for us is dead for a long time, and that's the explosion. They might have been sabotaged long ago. Whoever it is who put this vision here wanted us to see this.
Would you say it's some deity of sorts that left this here for us?
Only a deific power could do something like
this. Most likely.
Then this stone might be something to contact them with. Possibly.
Yes. If I may.
Yeah.
I have a feeling Uber blew up this temple.
He may evolve.
Stop.
Emerin, what do you see with a stone?
I grow my beard back.
No, I have it to him, so I pass it to him.
Well, I took it from you.
Oh, yeah.
Not even a greater restoration spell would be able to bring that back.
Oh, come on!
By any chance, is there any, like,
time skip
bit of level with that enchantment still
you
on
grow
it?
You grow 10 years, though. That's the only problem.
Can I do some sort of check on, like, religious-wise?
On the stone?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Probably be best.
Nope. It's a...
I try religion check on the stone. No, that's an 18 on the die, so 22.
It's not an artifact. It's not even a stone. What this appears to be is some kind of remnant, a piece of a deity of some kind.
I definitely hold on to this.
You got innards in your head, bro.
Oh.
Do you tell me this?
Yes.
A dead power. That last bit of power gave that vision to us.
A power that was probably killed by Uber.
Yeah, but what kind of part is it?
I mean, if we could contact the God of Chaos somehow.
Sigil?
Sigil.
That's if he even wants to speak to you.
I
ask my gun, Sigil, can you hear us?
chirp, 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 chirp. You can really hear crickets chirping.
Perhaps we should seek out the other items as connections to deities.
So, he clearly responded in a non-caring way.
Yep. Perhaps we should seek others out for help. So we have a castle to find.
Yeah, let's do that. I'm going to hold on to this piece of a dead god.
One last thing. I want to see, how badly damaged was the room that exploded and the statue. Just slowly make my way over toward there.
It's caved in.
Okay.
So the
there's nothing but rubble.
So the basin is gone.
Easily destroyed. Like,
could you make
the basin was the center of the explosion.
Could you make your way to, the top of, the roof of the temple? Through the cave in?
That would be retarded. And you'd probably just be putting yourself at risk.
That's fair.
I mean, it kind of caved in.
It's kind of... Not much of a roof. The skylight was the peak of the mountain.
How big is, a piece of the...
Oh,
a chunk?
My right eye's twitching.
The remnant?
Yeah.
The remnant is about the size of my fist.
No, not that. The
The clasp?
I'm looking at the statue's head.
What do you mean?
Is there, a piece of the eye, an eye?
Are there bits of the statue left? Yeah.
Like the head.
The statue has been broken into 100 pieces.
Yeah. I will say one thing, though. If you go into mainlands, be careful. It's like when there's guards crawling everywhere. And the Emperor will be less than happy to see visitors.
You are on the mainland.
Or, the capital mainland. Especially since I saw him happily throw someone out the window, including his own guards.
I
had to say that nonchalantly.
No. He didn't, He didn't throw the guard out the window. The guard threw himself
out the window.
It
seems he ordered the guard himself to die in his honor. What honor he may or may not have.
Well, the window might just be out to the ocean, or...
Surely
a castle.
Or ground level.
I was... No. It's a long fall, I'm
afraid.
What a
naive statement.
Like I said, I visited this land. I know for a fact... They're not alive.
That's some bouncy castle.
Are you saying you visited the castle before?
5 years ago, as I said.
Anyway.
A diplomatic mission. That went
poorly.
Let's move on.
I've already told you enough.
You sense there's nothing left for you here.
Yeah.
I make a small prayer. Do I get anything at all?
We've done what we can. The rest is up to you.
Is that what I hear?
Yes.
Was it the Lady Monk? Alright.
Who's probably the leader of the Covenant?
I wouldn't be surprised if she was.
Alright. So what are you going to do now?
I think there's nowhere else to go except for the capital.
From the peak of the mountain... In the distance,
we have about an hour.
You see the glinting, like glass reflected from that's reflecting sunlight
directly at us.
You mean me?
No, it's a.
I wouldn't
show him your head reflected back.
Yeah, thanks.
As your eyes adjust
you take
to
off
the light,
cloth I gave you.
No, I.
As your eyes adjust to the light. The skyline of a city starts appearing in front of your eyes.
This would sound great if it were like a movie or video game.
Yep.
And the capital of Fortuna stands in front of you.
Before you.
We should probably go that way. Yeah.
Tread with
fear. I know we've got an hour left, but this sounds like a great time.
I think we can continue forward for a while. Because something's going to happen. Something always happens.
True.
So, guys.
Well, we could just stop for the night for a moment, because we've...
You know,
we haven't done anything since
take
we fell
a rest.
Out of that plane.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, let's...
Lots of damage.
Long rest?
You can make campfire outside the abandoned temple for a day.
Sure.
Maybe in the temple, because...
No, you get
dangerous.
The feeling that would be disrespectful.
Yeah.
All right.
You dishonored them.
It's basically a mass grave that you just walked through.
We don't need rocks falling on top of us while we sleep.
Yeah.
I don't know about you.
It's obvious that this is the place of their death, and they're never properly buried.
Right.
Okay.
So you rest for 24 hours. The thoughts of it, of the visions you've had still very deeply rooted in your mind.
Skills!
During the night, I'm going to have a conversation
with... What?
During the night, I'm going to have a conversation with Jeremy's character.
Okay.
Emran.
Yeah.
I'm going to make bullets for my gun. Yeah.
After, and this all takes place after you guys have had your conversations about your visions, you go back to doing your own personal activities.
Yep. So I go up 12 points.
I want to take out that clasp I found, so here, I think this will mean a bit more to you than it does to me.
It's the same clasp that the monk woman wore on her robe.
Ask him how he got this clasp.
I don't think I need to. I found a smaller one,
mm-hmm.
which I think I'll bury in the morning.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Maybe you should wear that, like, to honor the people.
Yeah, I'll wear this bigger one to honor them.
All right.
And bury the smaller one.
Okay.
Oh, also during the night, is there any that horse we found that died? That's not real.
Do we find
that was quite real?
Okay, so I
you ever heard
the horse
about
meat.
Domesticated animals going back to being feral after their owners are dead?
So I stuffed the horse meat.
Yes.
What?
Okay, so we have something to eat that's a bit exotic. As I skin it, because I make him a fake beard.
Ew. Why?
It'd be a very short
because
beard.
I'm trying
no!
To be nice.
No!
Yes.
He doesn't
He's
like
He's not going to want
What kind of dexterity check is this? Slightly?
No, that's a crafting check.
What would that be?
It's like horse hair, tail.
No, that would be it. Like clothing craft.
Would that be
or
dexterity?
Like leather. Like, that would like be like leather wig. Work.
It's like that would take a lot longer than 24 hours.
Yeah.
Oh, just a shabby beard.
What are you going to do? Make it like a strip of leather with a beard carved into it?
Yeah, just take the horse's tail and just...
Oh, God.
Move it out a bit. He doesn't have to tell him where I got it from.
He'd see where you got it from.
He'd probably wonder why.
Where are you going to hide this?
On your face.
On your face, yeah. Here, you can look like you're an oriental kind of...
Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, boy.
An oriental dwarf.
Oh, yeah, boy.
An oriental
oh, boy.
Dwarf. 15
this is hilariously racist. Go it. For it. Go for it.
Speaking of hilariously racist.
Oh no. Okay, here's my question. Can we get more offensive? The answer's always yes.
Do you want this?
You could get more offensive.
Well, let's go worse. Give him a Fu Manchu mustache while you're at it.
That's what he was thinking about the whole time.
Yeah.
Do you want this?
I am a bad man. Do not emulate me, children.
Julian, can I make a perception check to see if it's
what?
To see if it's horse hair?
Yes.
You know it's horse.
It wouldn't be a very.
You know
hard
it is.
It's a DC 5. Can you roll a 5?
You rolled a 1. No, don't
joke. Oh, that'd been great.
It's
horse hair.
No, it's still a wig. It's a prosthetic. Just to wear in the meantime till you get something, you know.
People make wigs out of horse tails.
Alright, fine, I'll use the one in my disguise kit. There you go. I just wanted to see if I could get him to wear the horse hair one.
It's the wrong color, but whatever.
Well, how would you know? He's not wearing it. He doesn't have any hair.
He's got a shaved head. Yeah, it's fine.
I've got my brows.
They'll wonder why your eyebrows don't match.
What color are your eyebrows?
That's the color.
I don't think we've ever had to address this before.
Now we do.
I think they were brown before, but after what had happened, they're now like a bright red.
The beard's blonde.
Yes.
It's actually black.
There we go, black.
It's okay.
No, I...
Come on.
I'm not going to be fake about my beard.
All right, I'll wear it.
All right, you just wear your little disguise, a little cloth over your face.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right.
Like what Mad Max, like that sort of thing in Mad Max.
Which one? There's four.
What, the woman who's bald?
The one with the guy that has a mask on his face.
Joe?
Lord Humongous?
You'd rather wear...
Except there's two guys, you're right.
Except it's less of a respirator, more so like just a...
Oh, that was Joe.
You'd rather wear a mask than have a fake beard? You'd rather wear a mask because you're ashamed of your face than wear a fake beard.
So which what's it going to be? Is it a Joe face or a Humongous face?
What happens when you have to eat in public? It's going to...
Joe's the other guy, right?
He's the guy with the long hair. He's the villain. They're both villains.
The main villain.
Whichever one that had... Whichever one that...
Skullface?
Not Skullface.
Red Skull?
Hockey Mask?
Sure.
Jason that's Warriors? Joe. I mean, that's Humongous.
Well, the one that's, like, right here and not, like, all over.
That's Joe.
That's Joe. The main villain.
That's not a good description.
It is, because he's the only main villain in the thing.
In 4, yes.
Hold on.
There's more than one Mad Max movie!
Exactly.
He hasn't seen any of the other ones.
Heretic!
After Party.
Burn him!
Alright.
Be right back.
Where are you going?
Get my phone. Faith has probably texted me a million times.
I figured you would have had it on you.
Oh, okay.
Whoa.
Morton. So what'd you see?
A Morton Joe. That's his name.
When I did the visions you had?
Yeah, what'd you see in the visions?
Not that.
At first, I saw fear.
Oh, yeah?
Then, I saw myself.
What?
I was trying to think of maybe loopholes with this thing.
You saw yourself looking at yourself looking at yourself, didn't you?
Yes.
An endless stream.
Yes, I did.
That probably could have killed you.
Anything else?
It was weird. And then I decided to think of people without form, so I thought of Azeloth. And then I ended up seeing him.
You saw Azeloth? What does he look like? Who's Azeloth? I don't know that name, because I wasn't here at that point.
Creature inside him.
Azeloth is the...
Oh, no, I probably would have heard that mouse submarine, wouldn't I?
Yeah. You probably would have heard
it. It looks like a respirator.
But,
his thing is a respirator.
Yeah, but that's not what I'm
going for. Similar to Fear... Blue angelish creature.
Why are we talking about this?
Why does Fear have a form and not the guy in your head?
We kind of had a bit of a warping situation. Fear got a form and Azeloth didn't.
Is there a way we could do that for him to give him a form? Because that'd be helpful.
Sure, he might have lost too much of his power.
No.
To do so.
We could always find that out.
He was in bad shape when we found his physical body. Or his fear was not so much in bad shape.
Oh, well.
I mean...
But those
one
were
these,
the
maybe one
saw.
Of these items we find can help him regain his body or something.
I would assume the scales, but it would mean going back to the capital, our capital, and for all we know, that's probably more dangerous than any place you're going to now.
Alright.
So, dawn breaks.
I'll pick up a piece
long
of
rest?
It. Yeah, of course long rest.
Of course.
I'll pick up a piece of dawn. It's broken.
Wow.
No, it's broken on my forehead.
I'll wipe it off.
I have 4 points now. Oh, no, I don't have 3 points.
You didn't level up, Brian.
I thought...
Oh, did...
I'm level 9, but I forgot I multiclassed. That's what I
did... meant. Was that enough to level us up, though?
Not quite.
Alright.
Next time. We're not next time yet.
On Dragon Ball Z.
Yes, I'm kidding. All that stuff.
Okay, so let's...
Oh, I have my spells.
Let's walk down this mountain.
So is anyone hurt? Wait, it wouldn't matter, because we rested, Dirk.
I was at full health anyways.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep a lookout to the sky to see if I see any hawks coming towards us.
And I'm going
you don't.
To look for, what would I look
feel
for?
Feel a bit sad.
You'd look for soldiers or people that would want to kill
yeah,
us.
Yeah, exactly. Look for anyone who looks like they're in Fortuna and guard.
Do you have any... Oh, wait, no, spyglasses are expensive. Never mind.
Or maybe... The vampire lady.
You know what?
Completely.
I'm going to lift my eye patch and see if I see anything, whether it's soldiers.
Just look at the whole town on fire.
Oh, God. You know,
as a matter of fact, this entire area seems very well overgrown. And doesn't seem to end until you reach the capital city.
Well, one last farewell before the temple completely vanishes. I want to look at the temple with my eye.
I've already said my piece, and
just before it vanishes from sight completely, looking at the temple, like if I see the explosion happening or something.
We're just gonna. I actually kind of really want ice cream, so we're gonna end it right now.
So
fair enough. As you look at the at the temple
from a distance,
what you see is it hurts you on a personal and emotional level. Too much so for you to talk about. You just close your eye, and all you see are decrepit ruins. Good night, folks.
All right. I guess I'll hear about the behind the scenes.
And scene.
Okay. Oh, gotta see what's his name was.
We made it to the capital.
Andrew's character. Darn.
Well, no one cares anymore.
We didn't have enough time. I was thinking of that, but
I'll tell you where he is.
Dead.
Dead.
All right.
Okay, but I gotta ask something that we used to do over at New World. I would like you all to roll me a d20, please.
Oh, do you have a prize for us?
7.
Oops, sorry, higher.
20.
I think Evan won.
Evan, congratulations. Here you go.
I already have one of these.
I know.
13.
Jared did not tie, so yes, Evan won.
You can always share.
And that's it, bye.